So today I want to talk about self-limiting beliefs. Self-limiting beliefs. Okay, let's. Thank you all. Welcome back. Welcome back to the Divine Healing with Love channel. I am Nicole. I am so grateful and blessed that you are here with me today. Thank you. I hope you are well. I'm just gonna dive right into it. Let's talk about self-limiting beliefs. So, self-limiting beliefs, when you begin to tackle that in your healing, let me just tell you, it is heavy. It is so tremendously heavy because we don't realize how we literally trap ourselves in our mind. Like, there are so many things, so many stories that we tell ourselves, and we literally get trapped here and crippled by fear. So some self-limiting beliefs, let's just talk about it. Self-limiting beliefs are the type of stories and things that you tell yourself and that you believe in your subconscious that hold you back from moving to the next level in your life. Okay, so for example, a self-limiting belief could be you feel you are not good enough for success. Now, many people will say, "Oh, I believe I will be successful," but do you really believe it? And I think that that is the part that keeps some people from being here to moving here. You know, they stay here and then they don't go to the next level because they really don't always believe that they are worthy of success and worthy of all of the abundance that is here for us to have provided by spirit, God, universe, whatever you resonate with. So, for example, self-limiting beliefs will keep you in a state of crippling fear. For me, I'm just going to use myself for example. I did not want to start a YouTube channel at all. I really didn't. I didn't even think I would be on YouTube. I thought that I had this self-limiting belief of wanting to really kind of hide in the shadows. When I started my spiritual awakening, and I'm going to dive more into that as these videos go on, but when I started my spiritual awakening and I really just started diving into knowledge and just, you know, getting to learn more, I never thought that I would be on YouTube talking about it. I used to be the one diving into all the videos, trying to learn, seek this knowledge, but I never thought that I would be the person giving the knowledge, giving the wisdom. So I had a self-limiting belief that I was not good enough to make a video, to be this teacher on YouTube. I had a self-limiting belief like, who's going to listen to you? This is literally what I would say in my mind. It's really messed up, but you know, like my spiritual bestie Tipsy Tips says, if you're not listening to her podcast, listen to her podcast. It's entertaining and you get that healing. But Tipsy Tiff, her podcast, and I'm linking it below, she said, no, nothing is worse than the person in your head. And that is the absolute truth. Like, I literally told myself, who are you to speak on any of this? Who's going to listen to you? Who wants to watch you? Who's gonna even think you even know what you're talking about? What are people going to say that knew you before you really started coming out with, you know, doing tarot, talking about spirituality? What are they going to think about you? That's not the Nicole that they know. So that was really keeping me in a state of fear. And even now, I'm like, oh my God, I'm saying all of this. But, you know, it kept me in a state of fear. And it continued to perpetuate in many different ways until it just continued to cycle out of control. So, as you know, I do tarot as well. And I'm very connected to my spiritual team. And I'm going to talk about getting connected with your spiritual team in another video as well. But I'm very connected with my spiritual team, my spirit guides, my ancestors, my team of light, you know, the angels, the archangels. So they literally sat me down and said, you need to start making videos. Once again, I'm hard-headed. And, you know, you're going to hear this throughout my videos. I'm very hard-headed. I'm very stubborn. I'm very, like, you tell me I have to hear it about 10 times before I'm going to get it and actually execute. Like, I just feel like I don't really want to do it. And that's how I felt. Like, I was like, I don't really want to do this. So, but I'm happy to do this now. I just don't want y'all to think, like, I don't want to be putting out this energy like, oh, she don't want to do it. Why am I watching this? I'm just telling you all my story so you all can get it. But I'm very happy to be here. But it took me for other people to tell me. That was one thing. And then I went and got a reading, a psychic reader. She read me for Phil. I love her. Jennifer in Sedona. I'm going to put her information below. If you are in Sedona, Arizona, please go see her. Even if you're not, you can see her online. She's amazing. She's a master psychic. That was my first reading and I was like, oh my God. Like, oh my God. So anyway, so she told me, she said, you need to be on YouTube. And I was like, okay. And of course my team, they came through, of course. And they were really like, well, we told you this many times. Are you finally gonna listen now? So I'm listening. I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. I'm doing what I've been guided to do. But the self-limiting beliefs, even before I made this video, I'm still like, oh my God, what are people gonna say? Like, just continuing to just let that person in my head just go. Until I just face the fear and just do it. But we have so many self-limiting beliefs that stop us from doing what we should be doing because we get fearful and scared. You may have self-limiting beliefs around money. You may have self-limiting beliefs around, again, success, abundance. And I also want you to know the self-limiting beliefs, really, it's programming. You've been programmed from society, childhood, people in your life, whatever the case may be, all of those things, TV, media. We've been programmed to believe that, you know, for me, you know, my parents, they didn't tell me this, but just seeing things and how society moved, I never thought that my life would be going in this direction at all. I just thought that, like, you go to college, you get a job, you retire, and that's it. Like, this is what we've been programmed to believe. We've been programmed to believe that, you know, you work that one job, you know, no shade, no tea to the people that have done that, because I very much respect them. But, you know, you work this one job for 30 years, you retire, and then you go into retirement, whatever the hell that looks like. You know, we've been programmed to believe that this is just okay. This is the life you live. You know, you prepare for your retirement, and then that's it. And then I guess you live life then. And I always felt like I wanted more, you know, and I was around people who were definitely getting more, but I just didn't know where I fit in at that time. I didn't know what that would look like for me. And, you know, that's the programming. This is the programming. Go to college, do this. If you do all of those things, you go to college, you get the degree, you know, you buy a house, you're set. This is what we've been programmed to believe. So the programming is, that's the self-limiting belief. The self-limiting belief is, if you do all of those things, you're gonna get everything you want and you're set and you're gonna be good. But for many of us, we're starting to find out that that's a lie. What we've been made to think is, you know, the American dream, I guess, really is not. And that's not what we should even be aspiring for. We need to follow that passion and love within. And wherever that leads you, follow it and take the aligned action to do it. But stop holding yourself back by wrapping yourself up in your mind and keeping yourself bound by these stories that you've been told and the stories that you've told yourself. You have to break that self-limiting belief and stop telling yourself those stories. Because really and truthfully, it's not real. It doesn't exist. If I had been bound to what I've been telling myself, I would not be making this video right now. I would have kept telling myself, who's going to listen to you? You're no one to even be speaking on these type of issues. So why would anyone tune in? Because this is what I was telling myself. So I would have continued to do that. But no, I said, no, I need to stop being in fear, stop being anxious about it, and show the world what I know, and show the world who I am, and trust that this is a part of my plan, and stop limiting myself. One thing that, you know, I believe many of us have been programmed to believe, and again, that's more of the self-limiting belief. I think we've been programmed to believe miracles don't exist. I think we've been programmed to believe that don't believe in the impossible. The impossible only happens for people on TV or the lucky ones. And I'm here to tell you, you are lucky, you are powerful, you are amazing. Amazing, you're beautiful. So follow your light, follow your passion. Let go of that self-limiting belief. I want you to identify one self-limiting belief that you have, because the key is bringing awareness to it. If you can bring awareness to it and understand what this is really about and where this comes from, you can break it and you could take the steps to break it. So just think about one self-limiting belief that you have. Like I told you, I had the self-limiting belief that I wasn't good enough to share my knowledge with the world. So, you know, with these self-limiting beliefs, you could break it. You could break the fear, break the cycle. Identify the self-limiting belief, put the awareness on it, think about the origin of it, and then break it. Do something, take an action step to break it, and you will see that this was all in your mind and you could do it. You can have anything you want. You can attract anything you want. You could be whatever you want. You can reinvent your whole life. Literally, you can. So I want you to do that. And I want you to comment below and tell me about it. And tell me some self-limiting beliefs that you have, because I'm going to be making more videos on this self-limiting beliefs, because I'm very passionate about this and I'm very passionate. And I still have them. I don't want you to think that, you know, I'm completely cured of that. I still have them. They change, but I'm really putting the awareness there and really doing the work to make it happen, to break it and to step out of fear and take action to have the life that I want, that I feel I deserve, and knowing that I am worthy and deserving of the life that I have ever dreamed of. So I'm sending you all tons of love and light. Thank you for being here. Thank you for tuning in. Comment below. Let me know how this video resonated with you. Like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you in the next video. Peace. Tons of love and light. Have a great one. Bye.